So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِّنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته لاتبعتم الشيطان إلا قليلا. If it was not for the mercy of Allah and for His virtue, you would have all been following the devil besides just a few. But it's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that gives us all chances to go back to the Creator. Allah says, whenever good news or whenever news of security or news of instability comes to certain individuals who are hypocrites, they tend to inform everyone. Allah says, no, inform only those who will deal with it positively, who will understand how to treat that news and information. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the handiwork of the devil. And Allah says, alcohol, gambling, and all forms of evil, these are the handiwork of shaitan. You need to abstain from it, because what shaitan's intention is as follows. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this in Surah Al-Ma'idah.
إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُوقِعَ بَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ فِي الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ وَيَصُدَّكُمْ عَن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَعَنِ الصَّلَاةِ.
He wants to create enmity between us through gambling and through alcohol, and he wants us to forget and to turn away from salah and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person who's a drunkard, how close is he to the Creator? He loses his mind at a certain stage. May Allah protect us. A person who gambles does not have that iman in his heart to believe that sustenance is from Allah. He wants to start taking chances. He puts his money, they put their money, everybody puts their money, and he does something that's not in his hands. He wants to earn through that chance of lottery or through the chance of a casino. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. The chances are only one. That is being entrapped by shaitan. A person who walks in the direction of a casino is already in the wrong path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on us and protect us and our entire communities. Subhanallah. Nowadays, we've heard people telling us, you know what? There is a little musalla in the casino. Allahu Akbar. For what? For the Muslims. Because those are the patrons. If that is the case, how dare? On one hand, we want to read salah. The other hand, we want to do the exact opposite of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never ever overtake us with His punishment, because sometimes I think we overstep the limits a little bit too much. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us about how the eating of haram renders a person totally brainless. When a person eats haram, their brain ceases to function. And this is a very important verse. Once you put something haram in your mouth, your tongue is already cursing you, telling you, look, take it out. But we can't hear the tongue talk. The tongue is saying, why do you want to use me to devour something that's totally prohibited? Why do you want me to be cursed? Then the throat curses us. Then the esophagus curses us. The little colon curses us. The big colon curses us. The stomach curses us. The liver, the spleen, everything. The kidneys begin to curse us. Why did you put haram? Why did you put haram in this? So much so that as some of it is coming out, even that section of the body curses us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. That's how dangerous it is to put haram. Now the problem is beyond that. What about the blood and the meat and the flesh that was made through that haram? It is a curse in our bodies forever. So look what Allah says. And this verse is in Surah Al-Baqarah.
الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَا لَا يَقُومُونَ إِلَّا كَمَا يَقُومُ الَّذِي يَتَخَبَّطُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ الْمَسِّ.
Look at the word shaitan coming into the picture. A person who devours interest and usury. That interest, obviously we know interest is haram, usury is haram. A person who eats interest, Allah says, they will not be able to behave in any other way than one who is possessed by the devil. Allahu Akbar. they will not be able to behave in any other way than the one who is possessed by the devil, because they won't be able to distinguish between right and wrong. They will not see the light. You tell them the Quran says this, they'll tell you, no, I looked at it myself, it doesn't say that, I understood differently. Wallahi, their understanding is from haram. Their brains are made with haram brain cells. May Allah protect us. Because that wealth that went in was from the devil. This is how serious shaitan is. His planning is long term. Because once it's in the system, to get it out takes a very, very long time. This is why the narration says, when a person drinks alcohol, for 40 days the salah is not accepted. So now you have a youngster who comes to us and says, you know what? I don't come to the masjid. I've got another 30 days to go. You say, but why? So he tells you, because, sorry man, imam, you know what? I drank, you know. What nonsense is that? Whether you drink or not, you still have to come to read your salah. But the reward of it for 40 days, you won't get. Let me quickly explain that to you. When a person drinks alcohol, they still have to read their salah. But Allah says the salah is not accepted for 40 days. Meaning, if they don't read their salah, they will be punished. But when we all read our salah, we will achieve a reward. A person who's drunk alcohol for 40 days, if they read their salah, they will not be punished, but they will neither be rewarded for it. It's like a compensation. But if they don't read their salah, on top of being rejected, they will also be punished. So that is a clarification we need to understand. Not that some people, they look at the Quran and they say, no, I've seen, you know, the hadith says that for 40 days, so I've been given that grace period. May Allah protect us. That type of thinking shows what Allah says. They are behaving like someone who is possessed. They have no understanding whatsoever, no deep understanding. And this is the effect of haram income. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that about the eating of interest. Then Allah says, forgetfulness when it comes to doing good things is from the devil. And forgetfulness when it comes to abstaining from bad is from the devil. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am. That when people are sitting and they are saying bad things, and if you are sitting there, you must never ever keep on sitting once they begin to utter bad. Especially the women folk, well, the address is for men folk as well. When you visit someone and they begin to gossip, you know, nowadays the men gossip more professionally than the females. I wonder whether it's boredom or what it is. So when you are sitting with someone, they begin to gossip, it is your religious duty to stand up and say, listen, my dear brother, listen, my dear sister, you have begun to gossip. Salamu alaikum, I'm going away. Allah will have mercy on you. How many of us are ready to do that? Allahu Akbar. May Allah grant us the power, the ability. Now Allah says, if you keep on sitting with them, then that is from the devil. And if you have forgotten, then you must know that the devil made you forget. So then suddenly you remember, you get up and you must walk out. وَإِمَّا يُنْسِيَنَّكَ الشَّيْطَانُ فَلَا تَقْعُدَ بَعْدَ الذِّكْرَى مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. If the devil makes you forget, then as soon as you remember, don't sit with the oppressors. Immediately get up and walk away. Those who are oppressors, those who are doing wrong, we are not supposed to be in their company. Because that itself is from the devil. The devil makes us forget. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then also speaks about another very interesting point. In Surah Al-Kahf, we read the verses tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the story of Musa alayhi salam, when he went out in search for Al-Khidr. And the fish suddenly disappeared. When the fish disappeared, so the young man was asked, hey, where's our lunch? Where's the lunch? We're feeling hungry, come. He says, hey, I don't know. It's gone somewhere. I've forgotten about it. And then he makes a statement which was recorded for us up to the day of judgment. وَمَا أَنْسَانِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ أَنْ أَذْكُرَهُ. It was the devil that made me forget to remember it. Allahu Akbar. The devil makes you forget certain things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this in a few places in the Quran. Like Surah Yusuf. There was a good deed that was to be done by the prisoner who left. He was told that when you go to the king, just mention my name there. Tell him there's an innocent man sitting in the jail. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Yusuf, فَأَنْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ فَلَبِثَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ. Shaytan made him forget. Yusuf, meaning Shaytan made him forget Yusuf alayhi salam and forget to remember Yusuf alayhi salam. And as a result of that, Yusuf alayhi salam remained in the jail for a few more years. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about company and the fact, and I've mentioned this a few times today. This is a solid point, a very, very powerful point. Do you know that if you have bad qualities, most probably you got it from your peers, those you mixed with, sometimes they might even be your family members, sometimes even your parents. So if you have a bad quality, you probably got it from somewhere, but you didn't get it from Allah, you got it from the devil. That devil came to you in the form of possibly, most probably, your friends and your peers. So sometimes the upbringing in the home is very, very good, but the school you send your child to, they learn an accent from that school which is totally unacceptable. They begin to speak slang. They begin to sway, they begin to cheat and steal. All that is from the school. We need to be careful which schools we send our children to. We need to be careful what type of friends our children mix with. And bigger than that, more important than that, what type of people we mix with ourselves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Furqan, regarding the one who did not have good company, لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. Definitely on the day of Qiyamah they will regret and say, Ya Allah, this person whom I associated with, my friend, my bosom buddy, they made me forget you, Ya Allah. And definitely shaitan was very deceiving to me, Ya Allah. Now let me inform you, when a person is smoking, 9 times out of 10 they've learnt it from people they mixed with. When a person is on drugs, 9 times out of 10, it is from people they associated with. When a person is an adulterer, 9 times out of 10, they've learnt it from the company they have. When a person does not come for salah, 9 times out of 10, it is because that is the trend around the people they mix with. When a person is an alcoholic, 9 times out of 10, it is because those whom he or she is with is also like that. When a person has a bad mouth, it's also the same. And that is why rehabilitation is a waste of time if you yourself do not want to help yourself. Because I promise you, a person who's on drugs, a person who's an alcoholic, a person who has any bad habit, it is up to you to change. The whole world can want to rehabilitate you forever and ever, but if that quality is still in your heart, it is a waste of time and money for everybody to be worried about you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And this is why Allah says, if you want to save yourself, the first thing you need to do, change your company totally, totally, every one of them, change them. If you are a bad person on drugs, cut out your whole friendship. And parents of those who are on drugs, let me inform you, extremely important, you might want to change the suburb and the city you are living in order to protect your son or your daughter. You might want to go into a remote town so that your children can abstain from those they mixed with. It will do you a ton of good, even though your income might have decreased. You will save your children. That's the importance of the locality you live in, the importance of it and how serious it is. Your suburb, the area you live in, be careful, make sure you choose it properly. You rather live in a slum where the people around you all go to the masjid than to live in a palace where nobody talks about the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from evil company. That is one of the biggest plans of shaitan, is he comes to you through your company, your company, your company. And this is why we are taught, when you want to know someone, don't look at them. Just look at the people they mix with and close the file. That's it. We say this normally regarding marriage. You want to know a boy, you want to know a girl. More important than asking them about themselves, look at those they mix with. That's it. Close the file thereafter. If they are drunkards, they can turn green in their faces telling you, I've never drunk. They are lying. What are they doing with those? I've given an example and I want to repeat this example. When you see fish in the ocean, you will notice the whale moves with all other whales. You will notice the little bream move with other breams. The snook moves with snook. The hake moves with hake and so on. I'm using names of fish we eat actually. Subhanallah. But you will never find one small fish, one big fish, one other fish, one hook, meaning one snook and one hake and so on. You won't find that. The reason is, that is foolish. They have to have something in common to be moving together. The same applies to human beings. Someone who's pious and someone who's a drunkard, they can't move together. Really. It's like a sardine moving with a whale. Allahu Akbar. It can't happen. One will devour the other. Allahu Akbar. So this is why, let them not fool you when they tell you, look, I'm not on drugs, but the 10 guys who I mix with, they're all on drugs. Tell him, you are the boss. You are the main one. Don't lie. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our offspring. Remember, those who are tested with drugs, it is up to you, really, to change yourself. No one else. You need to develop the willpower and you need to make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our offspring from drugs. And may He protect our offspring from all these bad habits. Wallahi, there are good people who lose their children just because of their company.